If you're just joining us, my guest is Masih Ahmadinejad, and she's the author of a new memoir called The Wind in My Hair, My Fight for Freedom in Modern Iran. And she has led a movement of women taking off the hijab, the head and neck covering, that is compulsory for women in Iran. She's also wanting some kind of adventure in her life with the new freedom that she has, like she's alone. So she's both lonely, but she also senses this, she has this freedom and she wants to use it. And one of the ways she uses it, as we've discussed, is by watching pornography. So I'm going to read the post that you wrote when you started the My Stealthy Freedom campaign. And the idea was to remove your hijab in a place where you were free for women to, like, liberate their hair, liberate themselves. No, your body was bad.
My body was bad because I was
you were recording it.
Yeah.
The president's reaction when you sang to him?
And first he got really nervous and then, you know, he wanted me to stop, so he started to.
After covering human rights abuses and exposing corruption in the Iranian parliament, she fled the country for her own protection. In exile, she started social media movements protesting the law requiring Iranian girls and women to cover their heads with hijabs and protesting how men control women's bodies and lives in Iran. This is Fresh Air. I'm Cherry Gross. It's not safe for my guest to return to Iran, so she spent the past 9 years in exile, first in London and now in Brooklyn. Masih Ahmadinejad was 2 years old in 1979 when the Islamic Revolution overthrew the Shah and took away the rights of women. Her opposition to the regime started when she was young. She was imprisoned when she was 18. After becoming a journalist, she covered the Iranian parliament, but as a result of her reporting on corrupt officials, she was expelled from the parliament building and banned from returning. The first reporter to have that distinction. She covered human rights abuses in Iran until she was forced to leave the country. In exile, she became an activist against the law requiring that all females, starting at age 7, cover their heads and necks with a hijab. She started 2 opposition campaigns on Facebook. In the first, called My Stealthy Freedom, she asked women to take photos of themselves in secret, not wearing a hijab, and post those photos. Last year, Ahmadinejad's campaign, White Wednesdays, asked women to wear something white on Wednesdays as symbols of protest against the compulsory hijab and post those photos. Now Ahmadinejad has a new memoir called The Wind in My Hair, My Fight for Freedom in Modern Iran. Masih Ahmadinejad, why did you make the hijab your issue?
Oh my God, the first question is about like my childhood, you know, when I was 7 years old, starting school, I had to wear hijab.
That's when the law makes it compulsory.
Yeah, I mean, it's about the law, and my personal story is about my family as well. My father, I had to wear compulsory hijab inside the house as well. And if you see my picture, I have too much hair. It was not easy to cover them up. So maybe that was the reason from the beginning when I was a child, because I didn't have any, you know, clue about freedom of choice, freedom of expression, nothing. I just wanted to feel the wind in my hair, to be as free as my brother.
And you even had to sleep with the hijab.
Yeah, it's in my village, and all my family, like my mother, my sister-in-law, I mean, in fact, all the female in my family, they wore hijab even inside the house. And maybe that is why, because the school, social pressure, the law, and the family made me to be a rebellion.
So when you were living in exile in England, and then in the U.S., you started a campaign for women to, like, liberate their hair, liberate themselves, and take off the hijab and show pictures of themselves doing that. And, you know, this was at great risk to you and to the women who did that. Symbolically, what does the hijab mean to you?
Let me tell you, we are not fighting against a small piece of cloth. We are fighting against the philosophy behind it, and we never have the same freedom as I do here.
For women to, like, liberate their hair, liberate themselves.
So, and by the way, I have a good voice. I can sing for you.
Yes, I'm going to ask you, because you say in your book, I have a beautiful voice. If you want to hear it, just ask me. I'm asking.
I can sing the song that I, was a reaction to the
Please.
State TV.
Yeah.
It was about my homeland. It was a song from Afghanistan. I didn't know that, the women from Afghanistan can feel the same pain.
Please.
سرزمین من خست خست از جفا و شانه بشانه گشتم.
That's really beautiful. You really do have a beautiful voice. You weren't kidding in your book.
thank you so much.
What was his reaction? The president's reaction when you sang to him? And
first he got really nervous, and then, he wanted me to stop, so he started here.
Wait, they said that you started to undress under the influence of hallucinogenic drugs.
So I was in the middle and I had to make a decision how to react. So it was not easy, but I went to that subway. They said that I was right there, and I started to sing. Because singing is forbidden for a woman inside Iran.
So you started to sing, and then you made a video YouTube of that and posted it.
I love you. You know everything about me, and I love that. Yeah. That was the first reason, but...
Here's my stealthy freedom photograph on the Haraz motorway going north when watching pornography. And what they want or feel comfortable with in real life, in real life. And for some people, that's the same. Even though it might be hard to get in real life what you've watched on porn. But for other people, it's really different. You can be turned on by something with porn and not feel at all comfortable with that in real life. Please.